Hi, welcome to an Arduino step-by-step course by RoboJax. Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from RoboJax. In this video, I'm going to show you how we can use this MAX6675 chip module with the K-type thermocouple to display the temperature in Celsius and Fahrenheit on this LCD1602, which has only 4 wires. You want to display temperature either as degrees Celsius or degrees Fahrenheit on this LCD, which has only 4 wires from this MAX6675 module and then K-type. For that reason, I've prepared this video because many people have asked for this. I'm going to explain it. For this module, and in the module, we have 2 inputs that you connect this thermocouple sensor. These will have different specification, usually 600 or maybe 800 or 1200 degrees Celsius. So you will connect it in here. And on this side, we have 5 wires. This is the ground, and this one is the 5 volts. And then we have 3 other pins. This is a wiring diagram for MAX6675 thermocouple with LCD. This portion is exactly the same as before. These 3 wires is exactly the same as the circuit with where there is no display. But in order to facilitate power for the LCD and for the module, I have used from this 5 volts, I have brought a orange wire to the breadboard, and from the ground I have to this point. Now we have here 5 volts and the ground. From 5 volts, this orange is connected to VCC. From ground, I have yellow connected to the ground. For this module, however, for VCC, I've used purple to this point, which is connected to 5 volts. The ground of this screen is connected using gray wire to the ground. For the LCD, because this wire was going to the breadboard, the power, I brought also this one here. From A4, which is SDA, I've brought a green wire to this point, and from A5, which is SCL pin, for the I2C communication, I brought blue to this point. Now, this is SDA, this is SCL. And then from SDA, I brought another green wire connected to SDA of this module. And from SCL, from the clock, I've brought a blue wire to this point. It says SO. This is the serial out. After that, we have CS. This is a chip select. And after that, this is SCK. That's the serial clock. So the 3 pin will be connected respectively to pin 4, 5, and 6. This will be attached to wherever you want to get the temperature, perhaps in a liquid or in a tank or wherever it is, so you will just insert it. For this display, we have 4 pins here. You're using Arduino Uno, and then SCL is A5, and SDA is A4. And Arduino Mega, SDA is 20, and then SCL is 21, and Leonardo, and all of those. Actually, that chip, and this is the MAX6675. It can measure up to 1024 degrees Celsius. And in here, I've connected from the last pin. It's connected to 4. The next one is connected to 5. And the last one in here is connected to 6. Let me explain the code. This is the MAX6675.h. Include means include this file as part of this program, and this is part of the library, which I'll give you the link as and then you can download the file as zip file, and then either put it directly in under the library folder inside the Arduino, or the second way would be click on sketch and Arduino library, and then add zip library. once this opened, point it to the zip file. For example, this is a zip file, just select and then click open and it will be done. Once you include it, go to file and then examples, and then you will see Mac 6675 library, and I have example. I have modified that example here, so I will provide you this code. You can just run it, but those examples will see also be available. This wire is part of the library that is included. You don't have to worry about it. And then after that, I will also provide you the link for this liquid crystal display for the LCD, the same way as the other one, just include it with the library, otherwise it will not work. For that reason, I have another video that explains this one, how it works. I will provide you the link. You have to go and run that. You have to download that code and run it and make sure that at least you display some kind of text on this screen before coming to this, because this is a combination of temperature and this. So you have to make sure that this device works before connecting the thermometer or the K-type thermocouple sensor. So this will be part of the library that you download, and then this line creates an instance of this class. We call it LCD, and it has three arguments. The first one is the address. This is 16 character and two line. The address of your module might be different. For that reason, I will give you an I2C scanner, and that one also has I will provide you the link so you can get it. Here I'm running it. I've just tested it before. I'm running it. It's called I2C scanner. Let me upload it. Code is uploaded. You will see the address here. It says 0x3f. This 0x means hexadecimal, and 3f is the hexadecimal value. So it just runs and continuously every few seconds will give you the address. So once you find this address, just put it here. So this is the address for my module, and your module will be different. And then we have this three pin serial out pin, pin 4, chip select pin 5, and then serial clock pin, pin 6. I've written it here. After that, we use this class, and we create an instance of that class, and we pass these three parameters here. So this will be argument for this object, and that will take care of this. Inside the setup, we first initialize the LCD by lcd.begin and then lcd.backlight, which enables the backlight on. After that, we just, if I reboot this, you will see this text. Now I'm rebooting Arduino by pressing the reset button, and you will see that this text is RoboJax Max 6675 thermocouple. This is the text. After that, I use the serial monitor, initializing the serial monitor. Serial monitor is this monitor here that displays some information continuously. Whatever you see here, it will be displayed as well there. And that 9600 baud is the value that is here. It must match 9600, otherwise you will not be able to read the data. And this is also the text at the beginning. We give three seconds for the user to read this, in case if you have something special to display. After that, inside the loop, this is serial print. It will print the temperature on this serial monitor, which is this monitor. This is just printing Celsius and then Fahrenheit. How it does is that we say thermocouple, the one that we have created the instance in here, we just call thermocouple dot read Celsius will give you a Celsius. So this is the value for the Celsius value that you read here, and this is the thermocouple dot read Fahrenheit, that's a Fahrenheit value. This was for the serial monitor. Now we say LCD clear. Because this is loop, it goes every time and then clears the previous value. You need to have this. And this one prints this first line here for us. And it says set cursor at 0, 0. That means character 0 of line 0. This is line 0 and that is line 1. So at line 0 we say put temperature, that is this text temperature, and after that we go to LCD set cursor a character 0 line 1, that is character 0 of line 1, and then we print the Celsius, which is this value 21 now as you can see it, and then we say go to character 5, so 0 1 2 3 4 5. At 5 we say print this char 22223, it will print that Celsius. After that we say go to 6, the next one, and print this 6 C. So this is just for Celsius, and this is for Fahrenheit. So we go to character 7 and we create empty space, we just say print this empty space, and then we say go to character 8, which is starting from here, and then we print thermocouple dot Fahrenheit, read Fahrenheit, we'll print the Fahrenheit. After that, that we have counted from here, that will be 6 characters, will be 14. Again we print the degree, and after that at character 15 we say print F, so it will print F, and then we give the loop 1000 millisecond or 1 second, and it will repeat. That's why you will see it changes every second if there is a change. We can see that the temperature is shown here, exact same thing that you see here, it will be here on the monitor. This is the K-type cup thermocouple, and I have this Mastercraft from Canadian Tire, and I'm just blowing heat into this. So you just read the temperature here. As you can see, that's now this in Celsius, it's slowly jumping. Of course, in your application, you will not need to have both of this, but in case if you want Fahrenheit and Celsius, you can do it. Otherwise, you can just use one of them, and that would be enough, because as you can see, there was two decimal places, and because I put this here, that data shifted here, one decimal place has disappeared because I did not have enough room. But for you, you just move this decimal place one more or two or more spots on this side, this degree sign with the Celsius, or degree sign with the Fahrenheit, whichever you prefer. Very hot. Thank you for watching. This was how to use this MAX 6675 thermocouple sensor with K-type to display the temperature on this LCD. Please make sure to subscribe by clicking at the subscribe button in here. Thank you. Thank you for watching the tutorial from RoboJax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And don't forget to subscribe so you get updates of my upcoming videos.